We all have shoes that we don't wear from time to time, so the shoes you don't wear could actually greatly help someone else.
KTLA 5's Aaron Myers is in Valley Village to tell us all about this shoe drive that will benefit people in impoverished countries. Aaron.
Hi, you guys. That's right. These shoes are going to be donated all around the world. This is being put on by the She Angels Foundation, and they are an organization that gives back to other women's organizations. And you can see, since last hour, take a look, this pile of shoes, it has grown immensely. We've been having people come and drop them off, so this is some really good news. The goal is to collect 2,500 shoes, but I think they may outdo that number. I'm going to bring in Scott Williams, Deanna, and Brian. You may recognize these two from the show NCIS, and Scott is one of the executive producers. Now, fill us in on why this was so important for you guys to do this today.
I was cleaning out my shoe closet a few months ago, and I said, you know, I don't even wear half of the, my shoe closet, my closet. I don't have an actual shoe.
Closet.
I don't have an actual shoe closet. But no, I said, I don't wear half of these shoes anymore. What do we do with them? And then Catherine did some research and found an organization that passes these out, and she drafted She Angels, her nonprofit, that gives grants to female-founded nonprofits and organizations that help women and girls. And she organized this shoe drive, and now we have lots of people showing up with lots of shoes, and it's working out pretty well. So,
now, Deanna and Brian, you guys came out to volunteer. You both brought shoes as well. What is this need like for shoes? I know we were talking a little bit about that. We have some big numbers here.
Oh, I mean, it's absolutely immense. Almost 1 in 7 people doesn't have access to proper footwear in the world. That's a really huge number.
Yeah, and in this country, 600 million shoes go in landfills every year. I mean, like usable shoes. So, I mean, we're close to like 100 million here. So we're like a sixth of the way of solving this. So if you guys come on out and help us out, we could make a big dent in that and help some people who really need it.
And I have to ask you, was it hard to find shoes to donate? I didn't know I was coming here this morning, and I actually have a bag full of shoes that I could have brought.
I wish I did.
I don't, but I would say I would take one if I could have one. But was it hard to actually find shoes? I mean, you don't think about donating shoes all the time. It's such a good cause, though.
Well, as I was cleaning out my shoe house, no, but seriously, this is such an important organization and such an important cause. It really wasn't hard to kind of open up your heart and just give a little bit. You know, we all have a lot of us have a little bit more than we need. It's great to donate.
And then I want to see if I can put, is Kat in there anywhere? There she is. Okay, we're going to put her on the spot. Kat, we're going to put you on the spot this time. You got away with it so far, but I want to talk to you a little bit about why was it so important for you to start She Angels Foundation?
Because when I discovered less than 2% of all charitable funding goes to women and girls causes, and that includes like medical, like all kinds of medical, you only get under 2%, it got me a little mad. And if I got a little mad, I had to do something about it, because being mad doesn't just help. So I called all my friends and said, we're going to start a volunteer organization. Are you in? We'll give grants to female-founded and operated nonprofits to give to their causes. And so thus far we've given $110,000 worth of grants in 2 years. We started during the pandemic, and it's a membership organization, and it started with friends, and this is collective giving, and this is how it works.
And to see this morning, a pile of shoes has already grown. How do you feel? This is going really well, it looks like.
Oh, it's fantastic. All my friends are saying, I can't believe you already have 2,500 pair of shoes, because we're not a school and we're not a church. We're just a group of concerned citizens, and in fact that's the one thing that changes the world. And we're now making our first global effort to bring these shoes to other countries. They'll also be part of a micro business giving to help others improve their lives. And so,
well, thank you very much for inviting us to be here this morning. If you would like to donate shoes,
yes.
All volunteers here today, all volunteers. We'll go ahead and put the details up on the screen. If you would like to donate shoes, you can still do so. You can also go to SheAngelsFoundation.org for more information, or go to the email ccurrywilliams@SheAngelsFoundation.org, and you can reach out and find out how you can drop off shoes or have them picked up. And back here live, guys, take a look one more time at that pile. Lots of shoes. I know that they had more than 1,000 as of this morning. That number has grown, and you can donate shoes until September 10th. And on that, I'm Erin Myers in Valley Village. I'll send it back to you in the studio.
We love that. I have a bag. Casey has a bag. Mark has a bag. We all have a bag of shoes that we are going to bring.
Donate, absolutely.
Some shoes I have never even worn.
Awesome,
yeah.
Guys.
That's great.
I know. I wish I had the same size foot as you.
I know. I'd give them to you.
All right. Thanks, Erin. Good seeing you.